Hello and welcome to this spoken tutorial on filing a workpiece. In this tutorial, we will learn what is filing, various tools used for filing, different types of filing, how to file a workpiece, and common mistakes while filing. For this tutorial, we require a file, the workpiece to be filed, bench vise to hold the workpiece, vernier caliper to measure, tri-square to check the workpiece's squareness, hacksaw to cut the workpiece, punch to mark on the workpiece, and a ball peen hammer. First, let's see what is filing. Filing is a method of removing excess material from a job or a workpiece using a file. There are various types of files for various requirements. Flat file for rectangular cross section. Smooth file for getting smooth surfaces. Safe edge file for filing the right angled part of the workpiece. Square file for developing square corners and square holes. Half run file for filing semi-spherical surfaces, and round file for developing holes and round grooves. Let's now learn the filing process. My requirement is a 5x3 inch workpiece. The job or the workpiece which I have is 5x4 inches. So, let us first cut the excess 1 inch part. For this, apply the marking medium on the workpiece. You can use a chalk or ink as a marking medium. Once the medium is applied, mark the workpiece using a Jenny caliper as shown. So I am marking a little less than 1 inch according to my requirement. Next, use a punch and a ball peen hammer to punch on the marked line. After this, place the workpiece parallel to the jaws of the vise. Now tighten it to hold the workpiece in place. This is so that we can cut the workpiece easily. Next, take the hacksaw and cut the excess portion of the workpiece. Once the excess part is removed, measure the workpiece once again. Yes, the measurement is proper now. I have 5x3 inches. Now, let's start filing. First, we have to select a suitable file. I need a smooth edge, so I will choose the smooth file. Make sure that the handle of the file is securely fitted. Do not use a file without a proper handle. You will end up injuring your hands. Make sure that the file is clean before you start filing. Using rusted files will damage the workpiece as well as bruise your hands. So now, I have selected the proper file. Next step is to place the workpiece securely in the bench vise once again. Position yourself at 90 degrees perpendicular to the bench vise. Place your left leg in the front and right leg at the back. This is the best position for filing. Now, hold the handle of the file firmly in your right hand. With your left hand, hold the tip of the file, as shown. Ensure that the right thumb is pressing the handle of the file firmly. Now, we are ready to start filing. There are three methods of filing. They are straightforward filing, draw filing, diagonal or cross filing. Let's see them one by one. Moving the file lengthwise across the surface of the workpiece is called straightforward filing. In this method, the filing is done by moving the file up and down slowly. You can see that your workpiece is getting filed and the excess material is being removed. In draw filing method, the file is pulled towards the body with an even pressure. In diagonal filing method, the file is moved diagonally over the surface of the workpiece. The movement of the file is from one corner of the workpiece to another diagonally. Once the filing is done, we have to check the flatness and squareness of the workpiece surface. This is done with the help of tri-square and vernier caliper. To check whether the flatness is proper, place the tri-square on the workpiece as shown. Do so at three different places on the workpiece. Check this against a light source. This is a clear indication of flatness. If the surface is uneven, then you will see light rays between the workpiece and the tri-square. In such cases, you will need to file again. Next, we will check the squareness of the workpiece by using the tri-square. Keep the tri-square on the corner of the workpiece as shown. Now touch the edges of the tri-square on two adjacent sides of the workpiece like this. Check whether the adjacent sides of the workpiece are at 90 degrees to each other. If not, then file again. Another measurement that we need to do is to check the thickness of the workpiece. For this, we have to use a vernier caliper. Place the workpiece within the jaws of the vernier caliper as shown. Measure the thickness of the workpiece. Now repeat this at least three different locations on the workpiece. Identical measurement indicates that the workpiece is even in thickness. Now it's time to learn what not to do while filing. Do not file a workpiece at an angle. Do not file a workpiece at both the edges, skipping the center. With this, we come to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learnt to measure a workpiece, remove the excess part of the workpiece, file a workpiece. The video at the link shown summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops and gives certificates to those who pass our online tests. For more details, please write to us. Spoken Tutorial Project is supported by NMEICT, MHRD, Government of India. More information on this project is available at the following link. This tutorial has been created exclusively for the National Instructional Media Institute, Chennai. The script for this tutorial has been contributed by Praveen, and this is Nancy Verkey from IIT Bombay signing off. Thanks for joining us.